Aleister Crowley. Well, he's called the wickedest man in the world, but that's by the newspapers, so dismiss that completely.
He was an English eccentric.
He started off very rich. He inherited a large amount of money and went to Cambridge, but dropped out of college and deliberately became a transgressive
academic
person. He decided to seek out and explore new sins and to scandalize the society he found himself surrounded by, which he thought was awful and hypocritical and repressed. And his technique for doing this was using magic, sexual magic, and drugs, and anything that he could, and Occidental magic, and what he'd learned from the East, the Orient. He travelled in the East, and he brought this back and tried to start a sort of new church, as it was, the Church of Thelema. And he had disciples, and he was mad. He was deluded. He was a wife beater. He became addicted to drugs. But at the very core of him, he was an incredibly brave person, because he lived his dream. He lived the vision that he had a spark in him that was divine, and he acknowledged that every person had this. He said every man and every woman is a star. What he meant by that was that we should all aspire to be superhuman, not in a Nietzschean sense, although he was aware of that, but you know, to live life to the absolute potential and not care a jot for what anybody else thought. You know, if you wanted to dye your hair green and make love in the middle of the street with a dog, if the dog was obliging, you know, then then this was okay, you know. But it's the bravery and the persistence throughout his life and all the things he went through. His magical motto when he joined the Golden Dawn was Perdurabo, which means I will endure, and he did. One of our phrases, yes, persistence is all. You know, this is deliberately chosen. This is another magical motto that one of the OTO, one of Crowley's church followers, had. And I think it's so relevant to Coyle now, and to myself, and to the people who, you know, we're working with. You know, we persist throughout whatever. You know, we're not interested in trends, not interested in fashions. We're not interested in, we may dip into, we may be like a particular thing, but they come and they go. Whereas we just continue doing what we do, and it all washes over us. You know, we have a pure core that's very, very strong, I think.